From smartphones to bike helmet to bag, plastic has molded society in a such way that make life easier and safer. But have we ever thought what will happen if this plastic didn't get disposed properly? So hey everyone, myself Fawaz, welcoming you to FFK in cooperation. In today's video, we will going to have a look about plastic waste. So let's get into the video. Plastic Waste by Fawaz Fazal Khan. So here are the topic which I am going to cover in this video. As plastic has many valuable use, we are addicted to single-use plastic. We are surrounded by plastic, from chair to fan, from pen to specs, everything is made up of plastic. Around world, 1 million plastic drinking bottles are purchased every minute. Those bottles are used and thrown away. In other words, we can say that they are single-use plastic. Around 5 trillion single-use plastic bags are used worldwide every year. In total, half of all plastic produced are designed to be used only once. Plastic such as plastic drinking bottles, coffee mugs, plastic spoons, potato chips bags, biscuit trays, and many more. Only 9% of plastic waste ever produced has been recycled to make another useful product. 12% has been incinerated in open environment, while the rest 79% accumulated in landfill, dumped in seas and ocean. As we can see how plastic are incinerated in open environment, how plastic are dumped in landfills, and how plastic are dumped in river, sea and ocean. By 1950s to 1970, small amount of plastic was produced, so the plastic waste was manageable. As the world population in 1950s to 1970 was about 2000 million to 3000 million, and in those days people used earthen vessel, copper vessel and brass vessels. By the 90s, plastic generation was more than triple in 2 decades. Population of the world increases, demand increases and indirectly waste get increases. In earlier 2000, output of a plastic waste was more in single decade than it had in previous 40 years. As world population increases to 6,000 million. Today, we produce 3,000 million tons of plastic waste every year. In this graph, as we can see, in 1950s to 1970, waste and waste manageable was so close to each other. In 1990s, the difference between both bar become more, while in 2000, there is a huge difference between both the bars, and today, the difference become worst. Effects on environment. Due to incinerated, toxic gases like dioxin, furan, mercury, polychloronide, biphenyl are produced, which causes breathing problem to living organism. Even if you don't smoke, your lung gets same toxic due to incineration of plastic. Landfill causes soil pollution, and this soil pollution pollutes the groundwater. Filling land with the plastic make them weak and natural water become toxic. Animals like cow, goat eat plastic which are dumped in an open ground, due to which they die. The plastic gets stuck in their intestine, that's why they die. Dumping plastic in river, sea, ocean create ocean pollution. Plastic pollution in ocean is physically affected to several marine organisms and poisonous to human food system. Plastic does not go deeper in the ocean. They just form a layer on the top of the ocean, which create obstacle between the sun and the ocean bed, which causes death of several marine organisms. Plastic is not only harmful for human and animal, but also harmful for plants and trees. How ocean plastics are used? Companies like Adidas, United by Blue, Captain Blankenship, Sperry use ocean plastic to make their product. Those companies took a step towards cleaning the ocean pollution. Their main motive is to clean ocean garbage. Products like shoes, t-shirt, decorative products, sports kits are made using ocean plastic as raw material. Let's take an example how t-shirts are made with ocean plastic. This will help you to understand a little deeper. First step of the process is collecting of a plastic. This step is as similar as fishing. A large net is used to collect plastic from the ocean. Second step is cleaning. Once plastic gets collected, it gets cleaned in a large tub with water and bleaching chemical. Third step is separation. There are two types of plastic, named as thermoplastic, thermoset plastic both have different features and different method of processing. Fourth step is grinding. Plastic is grind into a small pieces in an indefinite size for further process. Fifth step is melting. In a furnace, plastic is heated up to 491 degree Fahrenheit where the state of a liquid plastic gets changes to liquid. Sixth step is making of a thread. Liquid plastic along with a desired color is put in a dye machine to make a thread. Dye machines such as injection molding, screw molding machines are used in this process. Seventh step is making of a t-shirt. Here the plastic thread fabric is used to make a t-shirt. These t-shirts are called as recycled polyethylene terephthalate t-shirts, in short form RPET t-shirt. It takes 9 bottles to make one t-shirt. Hope so you like this video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And if you think this video was informative, don't forget to share with your friends.